So today we're going to talk about one of the really cool features of Marketing Cloud Connect, which is actually getting information from Marketing Cloud back to Sales or Service Cloud. In the example we're going to review today, we'll be in Sales Cloud. And what we're going to sync back is actually very simple. If you take a look at this little contact record here, we're just going to sync back the subscriber status for Marketing Cloud. So whether they're subscribed, unsubscribed, held, bounced, you know, whatever. I have myself set up as an example in Marketing Cloud. So for now, we're just going to be subscribed and active. We're pretending we're a new contact and we haven't been synced over. So there's nothing filled in on the Sales Cloud side. And so to get that information over there, what we're going to do is set up an automation. And that automation is going to do two things. Number one, it's going to find all of the different contacts that we would want to update with this process. In this case, anybody who doesn't have a status filled in or who needs to have their status updated. And the second thing it's going to do is run some SSJS server-side JavaScript to call a content block that's actually going to contain the AMP script code that allows us to make that update occur. We're going to go into that in a little bit more depth here, but for now what I'm going to do is go ahead and run this automation so that we can sync that status back to Sales Cloud. If you were doing this yourself, you would of course schedule this, kind of like this is set up here. But for the purposes of this demonstration, we'll just hit the run once right over here. So you can see just from that simple process, we have our status synced back, and it's just sitting there right for us in Sales Cloud now. Now I do want to talk to you about how to actually set that process up. And one of the first things to know is that Marketing Cloud doesn't have any kind of IDE testing platform where we can look at our code and see what's happening on a console. So to get around that, one of the things that you can do is set up a cloud page. So we have a testing cloud page here, and you can run an HTML block in it. And what that's going to allow you to do is run three different types of things: HTML, SSJS, and AMP script. You can have all three of them in here. So we're going to leverage that and basically be able to output information once we're ready. So to set this up, what we do want to do first is make sure that we've wrapped our AMP script in a try catch block and SSJS. The reason we want to do that is because if the AMP script runs into a problem, which it certainly could, and it's not caught, it's just going to halt the entire automation. We don't really want that to happen. We want to have control over how we're going to approach that. So you can kind of patch together this SSJS, and you can see that the script just ends, and now we have AMP script, and then we can catch it on the other side, and we can even record a result. And this is the magical AMP script SSJS piece that makes this very useful. Which is this write function. So now if I go to schedule or publish, it's going to pull up a preview and you can actually see and record the results that you're going to find. So if I do something to this to make this SSJS invalid, and we can do it by just making this this way. What we'll see is this exception instead. So you can see that we start our loop, we cause ourselves a problem that is then caught, and we can actually output what that error is usefully. And then we get an end result, which in this case is nothing because it failed. but this is one way to make your development of a script like this a lot faster and a lot easier. Marketing Cloud Connect is an extremely powerful product and especially useful for anybody who has Marketing Cloud and Sales or Service Cloud already set up. The ability to sync that information from Marketing Cloud back to Sales or Service Cloud can be hugely useful for anybody who just wants to be able to look at things in Sales Cloud. It does require a little bit of setup, so if you would like any assistance in getting that put together and synced back and customized for your business, please reach out to us. We'll be happy to help you.